Ebola now has its own czar. Ron Klain is the latest presidential appointee with a prominent portfolio, but no Senate confirmation. Some recent history of President Obama's so-called czars, their value in crisis situations, and their political limitations, now on the New York Times Minute.
I always forget the full name of this thing. I call it the drug czar, but...
Back in 2009, as a new president, Mr. Obama named numerous czars to help in trouble spots. They were used to quickly demonstrate action as the country rebuilt from the financial crisis. But soon, the political limitations became clear.
Hey, we trust the president. He can point that person. Another czar.
Right-wing criticisms grew about sidestepping the Senate. Senator John McCain took to Twitter to complain, and the Green Job Czar, Van Jones, resigned after just 6 months amid right-wing attacks.
You are a troublemaker.
A troublemaker?
You
that's
are.
What I heard.
Others, including auto czar Steve Rattner, later acknowledged that he hated the title. After 2009, these types of appointees slowed, and the term largely disappeared from the president's lexicon. Fast forward to 2014.
We don't know exactly who's in charge. There has to be some kind of czar.
With growing public anxiety over Ebola, even Republicans have helped bring the term back to favor.
But there are some Republicans and even some pundits who are describing him as a czar.
Now Mr. Klain is tasked with leading White House messaging after days of criticism. Never mind that he has no direct public health background.
This is much broader than just a medical response. The response that you've seen from the administration is a whole of government response.